What's going on, folks? Ted from Nerd Immersion here, and it is the final day of Jetpack 7's Kickstarter Blackstorm Realms. I'm sorry if you've gotten sick of me talking about it, but it is the first kind of official published work that I'm involved in, so I'm very excited about it, and I just wanted to talk to all of you about it. So we are in, as I'm making this video, there are 12 hours left in the campaign. We have blown through a bunch of stretch goals. We are approaching 100,000 raised for the Kickstarter, which will add some new stuff. But I wanted to talk to you a little bit about some updates, some things that are going on, and maybe even get your opinion on some stuff before I design it. So, oh, well, look at that. I just jumped up while we were sitting here. So you can see here, the Kickstarter again is going for 12 more hours. I've already described it a handful of times, but it is a space fantasy setting, similar in a similar vein to Spelljammer, following that sort of mindset of fantasy game that goes into space rather than a sci-fi setting using 5th edition mechanics. And we can just kind of scroll down and see a little bit. There's a couple of preview videos out here. The art is fantastic because it's Jetpack 7 and that's just what they do. So you're going to get three new realms to explore, a whole new set of magic item customization called Apparatum, mechanics for shifting between realms, and, you know, a galaxy-spanning conspiracy, good guys, bad guys, and so on. So it's going to go on to who's in it. I'm involved, Celeste Conowich is involved, a bunch of the Jetpack 7 team as well. And then here are your pledge levels, right? $5 is beta access, or name the book. $25 gets you a PDF. $60 is a hardcover and a PDF. There's a box set as well, $85. The box set gets you an alternative cover, the hardback, the PDF book, GM screen, dice, a map, 28-page adventure, digital wallpaper bundle, and your name in the hardcover book. And then you can see there are limited edition, ultimate editions. For $800, you can get half-page art based on your character. And for $2,500, if you wish to donate, I don't even know if these are still available as of me saying this, you can get a mini adventure based on you or your character. Looks like there are still three left if you want to get the half-page art. And actually, the two that were getting an adventure based on you have gone. And then you can see here's the kind of what the base book's going to look like, and here's some examples of the higher end versions. This is the limited edition. This would be the ultimate edition of previous books that they've done. It just kind of spells it out a little bit, and then extra add-ons to get extra books and maps and prints and even mini, you know, STL files for 3D printed minis. And you can see all of the stretch goals we've unlocked here, right? Book upgrades, different art added in, additional locations. You can see there's a subclass designed by me at 60k, and now a subclass designed by me again at 90k, and we are approaching this final encounter plus map for 100k. But I also wanted to talk to you a little bit about my design for this. So if you go up here, you can see this is a PDF of stuff that Jetpack 7 has put together, and this is a preview of two of the subclasses in the book, the Blackstorm Sorcerer, Blackstorm Bloodline Sorcerer, and the Gravity Domain Cleric. So if I click that, it'll take me over here to Dropbox where I can go ahead and look at it. And you can see here, here's the Sorcerer. There's a lot of backstory information here explaining a little bit about the Blackstorm and what it is. And this is the first subclass that I've ever helped design. I didn't design it, right? I should rephrase that. I didn't design it. I just helped balance it, which is sort of my main role in this production, is to go through things with balance and make sure things are in line with what 5e has going on. So we went through a ton of back and forth. I've made additional suggestions to alter this, so we'll see. It may be different now than what you see here. But one of the first things I had suggested was adding in the Blackstorm magic table, because we knew Tasha's Cauldron was going to add new sorcerer levels at each level, and I said if they're going to do it on the new stuff, we should do it in ours, so we did. Another thing to consider, whenever we're doing any of this kind of design, we are limited by the open game license, so we cannot pull spells from everywhere, we cannot use abilities designed from anywhere, we have to use whatever is available to us. And then here's the Blackstorm field table, and then we have my cleric, the Gravity Domain Cleric, and I got a ton of really, really positive feedback from a lot of you, and then some criticism and constructive criticism at that, saying things were underpowered, things should be changed. So I have made a massive set of updates to things based on all of your feedback. So I originally had to give us martial weapon proficiency and heavy armor proficiency and arcana as a skill. All of you said These are granted magically. They're going to get Divine Strike at level 8. Let's swap that for Martial Weapons. So I did. A lot of you also rightfully brought up, at level 1, I had it that your jump distance was doubled and you didn't need to move to make a running jump or a long jump or a high jump. And at 17, you get the ability to fly. And a lot of you said, well, that completely negates the level 1 ability when I hit level 17. Who cares how far I can jump if I can just fly? So what I did was I added in your speed is not reduced by wearing heavy armor. And then I said you count as one size larger when determining your carrying capacity and the weight you can push, drag, or lift, using the terminology behind powerful build. Some of you think that that's great because in theory, it stacks with powerful build because it's not qualified as that. Some of you seem to be upset about that. I don't see the issue with letting you lift a bunch of heavy stuff. It's not like it's not game-breaking to be able to lift heavy things in the game. There's magic that lets you do this as well. But I don't know. Let me know your thoughts. Maybe I'll change it to just be it doubles your carry capacity, and then we remove the lift drag or whatever piece to the end of it. Then I have my gravity well feature, which I didn't really get any negative feedback on that. It's basically you can push or pull people 15 feet, and then you do that when you decide. And then if it would push or pull a creature into a solid object, they take bludgeoning damage equal to 2d6 plus your cleric level. It's a strength saving throw. And again, something to consider with everybody out there, if they succeed, there nothing happens. They don't take any damage and they're not pulled. So it's an all or nothing. It's not you take half damage on a success. And even if they're pulled, it only does damage to them if they're pulled into a creature or an object. So it's limited in its scope in that respect. And I clarified the wording a little bit. So in theory, if you pull somebody into somebody else, they both take the damage, and you get to choose who's pulled or pushed and who's not. So the chances of you harming your allies by pulling these people, that's really up to you to intelligently decide who to move, and then it pulls objects too. Now this one, level 6, friction control. Got a lot of questions. A lot of people don't like the name because it's gravity and then that's friction. And while I tried to adjust the wording to make it make sense in my brain and follow along with science to a degree, I'm very open to the suggestion of another name that lets you do the same thing. I just used friction control because it made sense in my brain. But I said you're able to adjust the gravity to alter the force of friction around you. Originally, all it said is while conscious, you cannot be moved against your will and you ignore difficult terrain. A lot of you said, that's too weak. Don't do that. It should have more. So we added in, you increase your movement speed by 10 feet. And everybody seemed to be okay with that. The big sticking point is the name friction control. So if you have a suggestion for a better name, let me know. Divine Strike as standard at level 8. And then Unbound at level 17. Originally, it said you can fly, fly speed of 60 feet and can hover. And then I said, additionally, you learn the gravity, a reverse gravity spell, and it counts as a cleric spell for you. Doesn't count against the number of spells you can prepare each day, giving you it basically as a domain spell. Now, the amount of you who apparently have looked at this class and not read the fact all the way to level 17 is very apparent, because everybody says, where's reverse gravity? Well, domain spells only go up to level, not you only get them at 5th level. They don't go above that. Reverse gravity is a 7th level spell. So I thought, rather than trying to shoehorn in an ability to give a cleric reverse gravity at level 14, something they don't normally get, and breaking that established mechanics, or adding in another, you know, line under here and then say at 14th level you get reverse gravity, again, something that we haven't really seen before where they break the way the domain stuff works, I stuck with keeping it standard to what we're used to in 5th edition rather than trying to alter things. So while, yes, you do get reverse gravity as a spell at level 17, you're getting it 3 levels after everybody else would have access to it, typically at level 14. And a lot of people said that's not enough. They said it should be more. You're getting this spell multiple levels later than everybody else, and it should be your whole thing. So then I added in, you can cast it once a day without expending a spell slot. And that seemed to be received either very, very well or not at all. So I just wanted to showcase off again this cleric with the updates, but I did add in a little something else at the start here. It's not been added into the book, but I added in a quirk table. I really like quirks in 5th edition. They're usually not something that goes along with a cleric, but I thought that that would be interesting. I also added a little bit of flavor text to try and explain gravity gods, since people seem to have a big sticking point with that. But I said, your ability to manipulate gravity around you can manifest in a variety of ways. At your option, you can pick or roll from the gravity quirks table to create a quirk for your character. And I thought this would be interesting in your constant and ever-changing ability to alter gravity. You little bits about you are slightly different, and I thought that that would be interesting. So I made a D8 table here. So for one, you glide along the ground rather than walk, so basically skating everywhere. Two, when you bleed or sweat, the drops flow upward rather than dropping to the ground. Three, you have trouble remembering that when you let go of something, it doesn't continue to float. Four, when you're asleep, you float 4 feet above the covers. Five, sometimes things you touch start to float afterwards, but only for a few seconds. Six, dust, rocks, and small objects orbit around you. Seven, you're occasionally hit in the head by fruit, most of the time it's apples. And eight, your weight fluctuates with your emotions. And I like the concept of quirks. I think that adds a little bit more fun. They're like a goofy thing that you can choose to ignore, or you could heavily build into your character. And I thought it helps give you a little more identity. And I thought that that would be fun. And it's going to make its way into the book in the final form. But because everyone's preparing for the end of the Kickstarter, I don't think it's going to make it into the preview sample. But you can see it here. And lastly, as we know, we broke 90,000 on the Kickstarter, so I will be designing a secondary subclass. And originally, I didn't know what I was going to do. I wanted to try to do, I guess I could tell you this, originally, I was going to try to do a gravity-based paladin, and that didn't really make sense in my brain because paladin oaths are typically, I mean, I guess you could make the argument for cleric too, but paladin oaths are typically more idealistic, like freedom or, vengeance or devotion. And gravity, oath of gravity, didn't fit right in my head. I didn't like that. So I went with the gravity domain cleric because I thought I could explain gravity more as a force of fundamental force of nature that gods could govern rather than as a developing tenets for a paladin. So then I was watching a lot of Star Trek The Next Generation, and I thought, well, what about the Oath of the Prime Directive? That would be an interesting concept. And that didn't really sit right with me either. So what I ultimately landed on is the Oath of Exploration Paladin. So exploration is kind of a concept you can get behind, and while I haven't developed tenets behind it, I feel like I could say, like, seek out new life, you know, boldly go where no one's gone before as tenets for this class. So I thought I'd give you a little bit of a preview of it right now, and then also potentially get some ideas for feedback from all of you for maybe things we could throw in here. So here's what I have. I did the domain spells because that seemed relatively easy to me. So I went with Comprehend Languages, Goodberry, Knock, Silence, Create Food and Water, Tongues, Arcane Eye, Private Sanctum, Legend, Lore, and Passwall. The concept behind a lot of these spells is they would aid you in exploration, whether that be sort of archaeology style exploration, like you're exploring old tombs, and being able to read languages could be really useful. Goodberry, being able to sustain yourself daily with one singular berry. Knock, to get into those hard to find places, or silence, to not be heard, or to silence and then knock. Create food and water to provide for anyone you're traveling with. And you could say that that's redundant with Goodberry, so that might be a swap. Tongues, to speak with the new people you seek out in the new civilizations. Arcane Eye, to explore potentially dangerous areas without actually entering them. And Private Sanctum, again, that's the open game license. It's normally Mordenkainen's Private Sanctum, to make a safe space for you to rest, sleep, and set up a base camp. And then Legend Lore, to learn about new civilizations and new interesting things to seek out. And then Passwall, if there's no door and you need to make one, you could do so. So I thought that worked out pretty well, but I'm open to suggestions. Let me know your thoughts in the comments. And then again, I need to come up with Channel Divinities and Aura, a level 20. And the one I kind of came up with for the level 15, because for a lot of the paladins, the level 15 ability is kind of a new, cool, always-on ability. So I basically took the language from the Necklace of Adaptation, because if you're going to be exploring and we are dealing with spacefaring and things like that, I thought it would be interesting if you could just breathe in any environment, then, whether it's the vacuum of space or underwater or what have you, you could now handle that. I thought that that would be pretty interesting. So that's, I just basically used the language from the Necklace of Adaptation, and I haven't come up with a name for that ability. But yeah, that's it. It was just a little peek behind the curtain on the design of that subclass. Also, some of you have asked me if I would do a series of videos on how I design these kind of things. I've never really done this before in anything more than fun homebrew stuff. So if you want me to try to, maybe I could do a live stream or sit down and do a series of videos of how I'm not really a D&D designer. I'm a guy who makes videos on YouTube and runs campaigns for his friends. But, you know, maybe this is a new side of me that I'm learning I'm pretty good at, or not at all, depending on what you all think. So if you'd like to see that in the future, let me know. Again, there'll be a link in the description to the Kickstarter if you'd like to go back it. Again, about 12 hours left to go. If you don't want to back it and you're sick and tired of hearing about this stuff, well, you know, sorry, don't worry, your regularly scheduled Nerd Immersion content isn't going anywhere. So thank you all so much for watching. Thank you again to Jetpack7 for involving me in this project and bringing me on the team to help design things. Thank you to all of you for the feedback and the support on the Kickstarter so far, as well as on my subclass. And yeah, I will see you all next time.